To my right is Mark Lankester, who's actually the CEO of Toon Hotels. Mark comes from the entertainment and leisure consumer goods industry over 15 years with Warner Music Group in senior management levels. Mark has actually spent extraordinary amount of time when it comes to hotels and actually seeing how recording artists has spent so much time in the hotels. He's totally committed to their mission statement of a promising great night's sleep, enjoying a fantastic hot power shower in the next morning, ensuring a clean and safe environment.
Thank you. But from day one, one of the most important things is we wanted to make sure that we could fight in a much higher weight class. And the key thing there is all about branding and marketing. I think what was interesting as well is we attacked it from a very different perspective. None of us come from the hotel business. We all come from the music business. And the music business is all about basically breaking artists. You build a brand, you make it highly successful, you understand your target market, you work towards it, then you actually talk about bleed marketing. How do you actually make that into a crossover hit? So we took it from a very different perspective. To us, it was primarily experimental at that point in time. But as Thibault said, and as Baron did say, the key thing there is understanding the target market. I think over time, initially speaking, we thought it would be primarily domestic, but across the seven hotels that we have right now, we're finding that it's actually turning into a 50-50 situation, 50% non-domestic, which is very, very healthy. What that does is you have enough international travelers actually experiencing the product. We're very heavy into marketing outside our traditional markets. We go into origin markets. So in other words, if AirAsia hypothetically is flying in from Orly in Paris, we'll advertise in Paris. People are flying in from Ho Chi Minh, which clearly they do, will advertise in Vietnam. It's not about necessarily the domestic market. So the overall A&P spend that we get involved in is from a hotelier perspective, probably crazy, quite honestly. But at the same point in time, I think our brand lives on the internet in a far larger scale than we would ever have been if we hadn't done what.
How basic can you actually go? I mean, when you talk about economy and budget hotel, take
for
instance.
It's a question for Mark.
Mark.
What's the basic?
I mean, how basic? It's like I heard no air conditioning as well.
Yeah.
Unless you have to order for an air conditioning.
We do have air conditioning. But you have to pay for
air conditioning.
I think when we first started, we did do some quantitative surveys and qualitative surveys just to understand, again, from not coming from a hospitality perspective, but we really wanted to come up with a consumer product as opposed to quote unquote a hotel. And the question that we asked was for less than potentially $25, what's the most important thing to you? By and large, everything that came back, first thing is I want to have a good night's sleep. Absolutely critical. Now, our interpretation of that is you've got to give them absolutely fantastic beds. It's about giving them great sheets, 300 thread count sheets. They don't really cost that much. Great pillows, 660 spring mattresses, 440 spring divans. It's a very, the tuned bed we sell. People actually
online.
Order them. And they get, yeah, people can actually order them and we ship them over to order them.
So I go, how many springs? It's lower? Or
yeah, I mean, it's a good point. But then on top of that, it's a good night's sleep. What does that mean? It's simple little things like having blackout curtains that some people just can't sleep when light comes in. It's about cutting away, in most cases, we actually will be in good locations. And there's always going to be, cars zipping around even at midnight and 1 o'clock in the morning. You've got to really make sure that as far as possible, that room is soundproofed. Going further, it was all about having, I want to make sure that I've got an absolutely cracking hot power shower. Because the image of $25 immediately is, you switch it on, it comes dribbling out, and 5 minutes later only then does the warm water shoot out. So we made sure that we had all those as key brand standards as well. Going further, cleanliness, absolutely key. Again, people had sort of images of cockroaches, stained sheets, and just horrible locations and rooms. Location, absolutely key as well. They're just saying great locations. Now, what is a great location? It's debatable because it's for your target market, and specific target market you would actually nail. But finally, at the end of the day, an interesting thing came up, which was security. We're finding that a lot more women are actually traveling. And the net effect is, I don't want to sound sexist or anything, but women are actually getting married later in life, career is important, and they travel with friends, like-minded friends in similar kinds of capacities. And the key thing there for them was all about having great security. I want to stay, and I want to make sure it's comfortable, I want it at a great rate, but I don't want to, you know, have someone sort of accosting me as I'm walking out. So all these things we put into the whole mix, juggled it around, you know, two hotels came around. But the key thing here is that, you know, nobody said, I need air conditioning. So we decided, okay, fine. The key thing, what we wanted to do is make sure that we're green, or as green as we can be. Energy costs are really ridiculously expensive almost anywhere. So we'll actually give you a great rate if you don't consume energy. If you want to consume energy in terms of air conditioning, we'll give you a time-based approach, it's truly pay as you use. 12 hours, 24 hours is our brand standard currently. You want it, you pay for it. We don't provide towels, we don't provide amenities. Again, most people are saying, no, I'll bring along a towel.
So how much is a towel rental?
It's 5 ringgit.
Okay, so after determining, say, what your clients actually want, and now you've built 7 hotels.
Yeah.
What are the new services you're going to, I mean, you basically get information from them. Are there any new services or maybe new products to actually?
Yeah, because the whole model in which we approach it is very much a cash, prepaid cash model in terms of free cash flow. Every site has to be able to spin off X amount of cash literally on a daily basis. It allows any developer, it allows any asset owner to literally fund most of the development costs of a typical Tune hotel, primarily via cash flow. And that goes into the whole conversation we were talking about debt as well. Nice and easy, but the key thing there is actually trying to bring up cash. We're old-fashioned business people. To me, it's all about cash. Cash is king. If you can bring in extraordinary amounts of cash first, and the guest will stay a year from now, I think that's a great business model. And it's how low-cost carriers have really built their businesses across Europe and, you know, now Asia-Pacific as well. The US is all southwestern. We will be adding different things in, and it's really just really at convenience. It's convenience, but it's a great business model at the same point in time. We're selling breakfast coupons online at the point of booking. We're adding in, we don't have TVs right now in any of our hotels. But all of our guests are coming back and saying that we love the product. We really like the whole pay-as-you-use model, because if we don't use, you know, we clearly save. But tell you what, if you actually throw in televisions, please charge us. So you should all listen to your guests, right?
Okay, so these are like what they say, box with rooms on it, right, or in it?
I wouldn't say that. Some people would. It's a simple room. It's spec'd out, I think, really quite well. We're on version 3 right now, as I was saying earlier outside. That may change again. And you've got to make sure you've, all the various, you know, things that we talked about have to be touched upon. But the net effect is we do get an awful lot of compliments of our rooms, oddly enough. A typical Tune, I'm always looking at ways in which we can drive our ARR down.
Your
IRR then? ARR then. Average room rate. If I could arrange it, actually, every day I'd sell it even lower.
So, I'm sorry, what's the lowest? Like, what is the base rate?
The base is probably about, for a single room in Malaysia right now, it's about 9 ringgit. Whatever that is in.
But eventually end up to how much when the guest checks
out? It's entirely demand-based pricing. So the net effect is if you, we do promotions continually, and that drives the brand. We're very aggressive in the actual advertising. Our Bali hotels, we started off at a promo price of something in the region of 10 US cents. But again, it's about actually doing true revenue management. And we've actually got a superb revenue management team that makes sure that demand-based pricing works exceptionally well for us. But it's all about, to us, it's all about ancillary income as well. The more ancillary income we bring into it, I have no issues whatsoever in terms of actually driving my ARR down. Because there are ways, instead of actually RevPAR, we look at it as essentially average revenue per user. Slightly different way of looking at it, but again, like I said, we look at this business very simplistically. When you get it right, it's actually very, very